Hey everyone, Greg Taylor from Trinity Web Media. Here's another bonus episode of The New Marketing Show. I almost said Trinity Web Minute, but we don't do Trinity Web Minutes anymore because we move the reels. Fuck, I can't keep up with how quick things move around here. So anyway, so I just did a reel about why you should work with WordPress professionals versus doing everything yourself. Now, there are certain things that we do want, enjoy, and, you know, expect maybe, you know, our clients to do when it comes to WordPress. You know, you should be able to understand how to create a page, how to create a blog post, how to go ahead and do simple SEO stuff when you create said pages and blog posts. But when it comes to the other things, the technical things, adding plugins. Now, adding plugins is super simple. But as we found out, or as a client of ours found out, add the wrong plugin and it could take everything down. You know, we had a client who added a plugin who wasn't tested with the current version of WordPress. There's a vulnerability. All of a sudden, the site got hacked. You know the rest of the story. So when, you know, when you're working with somebody, you should at least understand the roles and stay in your own lane. Creating content, pushing out content, and again, going back to very basics of WordPress, democratizing publishing is amazing, you know. I don't think that when, you know, Matt and et al. Fork B2 and came to begin WordPress and then see WordPress where it is today, that they had a vision or they knew it was going to be as powerful as it was the power, you know, 30%+ of the web, if not higher now, you know. But the thing is that there's still technical shit that goes on with that. There's still a lot of code that makes things work. You know, plug and play, like, yes, you plug in a plugin, obviously, and you turn it on, you activate it, and then it starts working. Yeah, that's because of the code that's behind it. It makes it so that it's simple. But if that code is outdated or deprecated, or it just, there's nothing supporting it any longer, it's gonna do more harm than good. It's going to do more damage to the site than it's going to give you benefits for the functionality that it's adding. So things that you should rely on a WordPress developer to do is any kind of technical theme changes, any type of writing CSS, any type of writing HTML, PHP, JavaScript, jQuery, any of that stuff. Just don't tinker with it. Just hire somebody to do it. Make sure that you have somebody looking after your hosting. Make sure you have some, and managed hosts are fantastic. There's great managed hosts out there, such as WP Engine, Pagely, Flywheel, I think, does it. Liquid Web, to some extent, who's our host of choice. You know, make sure that somebody is looking after your hosting. Make sure somebody is doing all your updates. Make sure somebody's taking care of your backups. You know, all of this stuff is a business expense. But if you look at it as just an overhead expense, then you're kind of missing the point. This should really be looked at as an insurance policy. How much is it going to cost? Let's say you run an e-commerce site and you bring your own site down. Then you scramble to hire somebody. Then they kick into emergency mode, and if they can fit you into the schedule, and then diagnose your problem. How much did that cost you in downtime? You know, so a lot of times WordPress developers should be looked at as insurance policies, not just added business expenses, because we make sure that things run well. And if something should happen, we always have a backup and a restore point to make sure that you're okay. Heed the warning. And again, you know, if you want to run a WordPress site for your business, we suggest that you get the best WordPress training out there possible. There are tons of online resources. Or hire a local developer who actually is willing to sit down and train you. So, hey, thanks for checking us out. You know, we hope everybody's being safe. You know, this COVID stuff is, you know, a lot of people are vaccinated. A lot of people are trying to ditch the masks. A lot of people are, you know, changing kind of our paradigm with things. So make sure you stay safe out there. Make sure you stay smart. And we'll continue to send you videos. Thanks.